you have described yourself as someone who's not particularly a hip-hop fan.
Totally not, yep.
And not a big listener. I imagine you probably haven't listened to most of the albums of your clients, maybe a few, but not a big listener otherwise. For people who are here, who might be maybe equally distant from hip-hop culture, talk about what it is that resonated for you when you started to learn about these clients. Like, what's the value of what they do? What's the impact? What's the resonance? Like, what's going on with hip-hop that you think makes these people worth giving a proper, robust defense?
Well, that's an important question, because I think that hip-hop and the treatment that it gets, other than the, you know, you see some of the signings they'll get with, you know, advertisers, a lot of that, of what you see, particularly when things are not going well, is really a statement on the way that particularly black young men are treated in America. A lot of hip-hop is in your face, we are young black men. And that makes white folks really uncomfortable. White adult folks, the young kids that all go surging to the stage. The first time I went, was...
You mean to a hip-hop concert?
To a hip-hop concert. I went after I had represented Offset and got him out after 9 months in a case, and I had promised a couple people, including him, I'd go see him. And I will tell you, the 85% young white audience threw me off. And when Lil Yachty started singing, who was unknown at the time, when he started singing and I saw all these white kind of fraternity guys like surging out of their seats to the stage, I was like, this is nuts. This is, and knew every word to his song. But when things go wrong, when there's a problem, then the finger pointing starts. Then it's, let's bash the lyrics, and let's bash the clothes, and let's bash the concepts. Even though there's not been a musical genre in the history of our nation that is making more money. Because let me tell you something, when you go to a cool hip hop birthday party in Beverly Hills, like I've gone to, the white executives can't get there fast enough. So everybody's cashing their checks except when things go sour.